I really like how 1 John 2 verses 8 to 12 sums up everything I said so well. What happens when you let Jesus take over your life? How does his ultimate makeover change us? How will our lives be different? Again, a new commandment I write to you, which thing is true in him and in you, because the darkness is past and the true light now shined. He that says he is in the light and hates his brother or sister is in darkness even until now. He that loves his brother or sister abides and lives in the light, and there is none occasion of stumbling in him to trip him up. But he that hates his brother or sister is in darkness, and walks in darkness, and knows not where he's going, because that darkness blinded his eyes.
I write to you, little children, because your sins are forgiven you for his name's sake.
Jesus looked on these men, the slaves of malice, whose thoughts were on revenge, and sadly answered, "Truly, truly I say to you, whoever commits sin is the slave of sin." They were in the worst kind of prison. They were ruled by the spirit of evil. Every soul that refuses to give himself to God is under the control of another power. He is not his own. He may talk of freedom, but he is in total slavery. He is not allowed to see the beauty of truth, the brilliance of the Bible treasures, because his mind is under the control of Satan. While he flatters himself that he is following his own skillful plans, he is actually obeying the will of the Prince of Darkness. Christ came to break the chains of sin slavery from the soul. If the Son shall set you free, you shall be free indeed. The law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus sets us free from the law of sin and death, Romans 8, verse 2. In the work of redemption rescue from sinning under your Satan, your cruel slave driver, there is no force. There's no outside force. God doesn't want us to be robots. Under the influence of the Spirit of God, man is left free to choose whom we will serve. In the change that takes place when the soul surrenders to Christ, there is the highest sense of freedom. The expulsion kicking out of sin is the act of the soul itself. True, we have no power to free ourselves from Satan's control. But when we desire to be set free from sin and in our great need cry out for a power out of and above ourselves, the powers of the soul are freely given with the divine energy of the Holy Spirit, and they obey the dictates of the will in fulfilling the will of God. So the Holy Spirit gives us the power to do all of God's ways and choices. The only condition which the freedom of man is possible is that of becoming united with Christ. The truth shall make you free in Christ is the truth. Sin can triumph only by enfeebling the mind and destroying the liberty of the soul. Giving your choices to God is the only way of the restoration to oneself. This is the true glory and dignity of man. The divine law, to which we are brought into guiding all our choices, is the royal law of liberty, James 2 verse 12. Amen.
Day by day and hour by hour, your love for me from heaven flows like streams of water.